Hello, everybody. Thank you for being here today at this great conference. My name is Johann Polecsak, CTO and co-founder of QANplatform. And today I'll be talking to you about how to bring significantly more people, I mean developers, to the blockchain space so we can develop more crazy and useful apps, because this is what will truly drive mass adoption. I also seem to have a problem with the clicker. Okay, so who here in the room knows what Solidity is? Okay, so that's great. But as we see, it's a pretty limited subset of people who know this language. And if you take a look at the numbers, I mean, there are close to 27 million developers on the planet, and only 0.74% out of these people know this language. But let's take a step back, and let's take a look at that. We are close to 8 billion people on the planet, and yet only 0.3% of them are developers, which means that all this digital content, all these cool tech products we are using today are built by such a tiny fraction of these people. And to make it even worse, only such a tiny sub-fraction of these people know this language. And it's extremely hard to scale. So blockchain platforms force people into learning this language. So if you are into Web3 or decentralized finance, DeFi, Metaverse, you name it, you must learn this language. So all these platforms listed here, Ethereum, Binance Smart Chain, Polygon, I don't need to go through all of them. They require you to have this language so you can use it and you can build decentralized applications. Whereas these are the most loved and most well-known programming languages on the planet. So although this very event we are here at today is a blockchain-focused one, I'm pretty sure that out of these developers who are sitting here together with us, a vast majority knows JavaScript, Python, all these familiar languages more than Solidity. And there are more JavaScript developers, for example, than Solidity developers among us. And it's also important that, as you see, there is a big overlap among these languages. And the reason for that is that developers love to learn more languages because they can use it for much more use cases. So they don't like to focus on some niche language which has only a single purpose, which Solidity is such a language. Okay, and all this, what I just explained, is severely blocking mass adoption and new use cases. And the reason for that is that, as I said, forcing developers to learn a new language, that's not the easy way. I mean, if you're already a developer and you want to jump straight into blockchain and start to try building decentralized applications, you just can't do that. There is an entry barrier in front of you, which is having to learn the language, Solidity itself. The second problem is that I guess not that many people out of you are developers, but just to give a bit of context and background, the language itself is really, really similar to JavaScript, which is like the most prominent, the most well-known language on this planet. And this gives developers a false sense of understanding, a false sense of confidence, because as a developer, you will feel that, okay, I could learn this stuff in 5 days, and it's pretty similar. I know the syntax. It looks familiar for me. But you will forget that in this context, I mean the blockchain context where these decentralized applications are used and they are executed, and it's a completely different execution runtime. It's a completely different environment. So you will make mistakes, which can be fatal in such context, of course. This imposes high security risks, which most of the, not just private individuals, people are afraid of, but also companies. I mean, who wants to bring out a new product as a company which imposes such high security risks? And imagine the scenario that a company which is learning about blockchain wants to use blockchain technology inside their operations would be more comfortable with, like, hey guys, please go for a 6-month boot camp to learn this new language, this new technology, and let's build something for our company. or would they be more comfortable telling their existing developer team who they have been working with together for the last 40 years that, hey, we need some kind of new solution which could be a perfect fit for a blockchain application. Could you build that in a language which you have mastered for the last 20 years, right? And yes, again, extra cost because it's a thing. I mean, it's also blocking mass adoption that you need to find these new people, you need proper training, you need to pay the audits. So it's, if you want to do blockchain stuff properly, it really gets expensive. So meet QANplatform. QANplatform is the world's first blockchain platform which enables people to build literally in any programming language which can be compiled to a Linux kernel and is capable of running on Linux, which is pretty much everything, right? So QANplatform has developed the world's first hyper-polyglot smart contract engine. So the way this works is that anything, literally anything, and I don't want to go too deep tech here because I know that's not this part of the event, but any language which can be compiled to a static binary which is capable of running on Linux can be used on QANplatform. So essentially, this literally means every single language. So there are workarounds which you can use to make them run on QAN's blockchain platform. And let's take a look at the numbers, because as in the beginning, we have listed all the platforms which are mainstream today and people use for building decentralized applications. We bring a solid 13,400% increase in the pool of developers who are capable of building on blockchain from now on. So we really believe that this will be a huge added value and a massive impact in the blockchain space, because right now, all those coders, all those developers who are either self-motivated, I mean, building applications for themselves, or are working for a company as an employee, they all have motivations. And motivation for someone who is just building for fun is like going home, exploring new libraries, trying out new stuff. And again, here is, it's really important to highlight the ease of entering a new technology, because if you are a professional coder and you go home, you are already tired, you have like 30 minutes, in an optimistic case, 2 hours to look up new stuff, try out new stuff. It should be pretty easy to give a self-affirmation, a quick self-feedback that I tried this thing, I built this thing, and it ran. And now I have the feeling of understanding, of I know what I'm doing. It's not so with blockchain today. And again, back to the motivation. So if I'm developing for myself for fun, I will build something, I might send it to my friends to try it out, and I can do so in literally 1 or 2 days at most. I can build something on QAN, whereas there would be a much steeper learning curve for any other blockchain platform. And also for a company, if you are hired by a company, you will build something for your company, and eventually your company will promote it. So either way, there is a spread of information, because either you build it and send it to your friends to show off what kind of cool thing you just did, or you just build something for your company, who will obviously pay for that and market it, so bring it onto the market. So either way, either category, we are reaching more people. As for how do we pull this off, it's through QVM, which stands for QAN's virtual machine. And again, I don't want to dive too deep down into the internals. It's all about creating a runtime, because there are many scripting languages, there are many systems languages on this list that you can see. And it's all about bundling the runtime into an executable program, which doesn't have any external dependencies and can run on Linux. I really don't want to go deeper into the left part of this slide, but to the right part. So you can use all these cool languages you already know and millions of people already know to build all the applications we love having, like DApps, DeFi, DAOs, NFTs, all the cool stuff there is currently on the blockchain. So what are the benefits for the blockchain ecosystem? So, as I said, they can use the languages Sorry, can you hear me? Okay. So they can use all the languages they have previously learned and have been doing and have been writing programs in for the last 20 years. So they are much more confident in creating such applications in a language. They have a rock solid experience with it. And confident knowledge also means much, much lower security risk, because this is just natural. If you have, as I said, mastered something for the last 20 years, you are much less likely to make security-related issues in your code. And then the next one, which is also a big driving factor, as I said, is much, much lower cost for companies. So instead of relying on external developers, outsourcing blockchain technology, because always think about it that blockchain technology currently is mostly used for making financial-related transactions. And financial-related transactions are obviously sensitive, so that's definitely something you want to keep in-house, to build these kinds of applications with your core team, which you have relied on in the past, instead of just outsourcing it to some third-party company. And by doing so, we enable companies to do just that, use their existing in-house human resources they already trust, they already know, to build all these applications with zero overhead. As opposed to, as I said, relying on third parties, which can be costly, who might be unreliable. It's really hard today to find proper companies operating up to certain standards. I mean, like ISO standards, who are developing blockchain applications. Most of them like these magical hackers in hoodies who will promise that they will build you these cool smart contracts and might not follow up on it, and there could be issues. Yes, I still have some time left, so I will also tell you a bit about how knowledge investment works with QVM, because this is the next type of thing which was never seen back on the blockchain. So in the next stage of QVM, we will also provide a deterministic build environment. This means that all the code you write will be deterministically inspected, whether it contains newly built constructs in the language, which you just supplied as fresh code to the blockchain, or whether you are importing or reusing other people's work. And based on that, we will be able to give royalties to the people. And all of this is happening fully decentralized, as the blockchain is itself. So it's a motivation to build code which is easy to import, easy to reuse, and easy to consume for other developers. Because when you deploy an application, the deployment fees are determined based on how much code you have reused from other stuff as a foundation layer, and how much of custom code you have written on top of that, so which is obviously specific to your application. This way, people are motivated to write easy to import, easy to reuse code. Developers are also motivated to look up the libraries, what other people have built, because it will be much cheaper for them to deploy imported code, because it will be there will be less fees charged for those pieces of code which already exist in the libraries. And also, this fractional amount would not be paid to the network itself, I mean to the validators, but this amount would go directly to the coders who have written the original piece of code. So this way, we create an ecosystem where people invest with their knowledge, where people invest with their code, where people think through what other developers could use their built modules for. So this brings a big change in the mindset of the developers who can now literally invest with their knowledge. So thank you very much for listening to me today. I hope to see you soon on QANplatform. We will also be hosting a workshop this afternoon at 1:40 p.m. I pretty much welcome everybody who is interested for a more tech-related workshop. Thank you very much for your attention.